Hi, I'm Chris Page, also known as DC Breaks, and I'm here at the EBS Institute to do a really deep dive into re-space and modern drum and bass sound design. So actually, now that was really distorted, that might be a good point to jump into a 30-bit audio demo. So as of, this is Logic 10.7.6, I think from 10.7.5, they finally added 32-bit native recording. So I'm not talking about the summing or the word length of the processing, I'm talking about the dynamic range that you can capture in a recording. So with a 16 or 24-bit standard recording, you know, you have 0 dB, you go above that, it clips, it squares off, okay? Which, when you're making some bass sounds, can be done tastefully. With a 32-bit floating point, you can capture a recording, and even if it goes above 0 dB, it will still be able to recreate that as a digital signal. So the reason why that's handy, because at some point you're going to have to convert to 24-bit or 16-bit anyway, but the reason why it's handy is when you're making some of these sounds, or really any recording sound, it means you don't really have to worry about the level, because if it goes above 0 dB, you can just later go back and turn it back down, and you're not going to capture any distortion that was clipping distortion that was kind of captured by recording over 0 dB. So let's just do a quick demonstration of that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the sound right down so I don't blast you all. I'm going to whack the gain up like 24 dB. Maybe I just need to go right down. Here we go. There we go. Right. So I'm just going to play, and I don't know what I'm going to play. I'm just going to capture something. So let's say I'm trying to make a bass line. I'm like, meh, 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 meh. You can see it's like going massively above 0 dB. If I now just bounce that in place, we can see straight away looking at it how clipped and distorted it is over zero there. And again, if we can look in the arrange window here and see that that's the case. If I play it back very quietly. Oops, sorry, there we go. You can hear how distorted that is. But because it's been captured in 32-bit floating point, we can rescue it essentially. So if I just now apply the same gain, take it down however much, and re-render it off, we can see now, if we go into it, that it isn't, I've kind of turned it down too much there, but you can see that it's kind of not distorted. So that's really handy. No, there's no clipping there at all. So that's really handy. I don't know whether live is kind of also supporting 32-bit now, but essentially you go from having a dynamic range of, you know, in a 24-bit situation from 0 dB down to like minus 144. In 32-bit audio, the dynamic range is like 1530 decibels. So it goes over zero up to like 735 decibels or something, and then down minus 735 decibels, which is pretty much almost greater than the possible loudest, like a supernova exploding, down to like, you know, a mouse, like, you know, whispering or whatever. So it's just kind of almost pointless, but it does have a practical implication within Logic. Does anyone have any questions about that, or kind of, yeah?
Yeah, so how did you go about recording in 32-bit? Was it when you bounced it out?
Yeah, so it's just natively now within Logic, it does that. So it's, I don't think you need to turn it on. When you render, if I was going to like go to bounce and bounce that out, you can choose, you know, a different resolution, and then at that point you can choose 32-bit float. But when you, because yeah, in live you can't kind of bounce in place like that, but it just does the same thing, but kind of offline. And so yeah, it's just using that 32-bit processing. So. I'm personally very grateful for that. If you're doing any kind of content creation, recording stuff, and it comes out clipped, you know, it can be a bit of a disaster. You have to go back and, if it's distorted, kind of redo stuff. Or any kind of recording, you're making music as well, obviously. It's a bit of a lifesaver. I hope you enjoyed that session. If you want to see more videos like this, just head over to the DBS Institute YouTube channel now.